Hey guys, Devo343 are back with another video. Today we are looking at a new War of the Worlds survival game that me and another friend have been making over the past like 15 days. It's not even finished yet. It's very, very bare bones. It will be released to the public tomorrow as of this video, May 30th. But yeah, I know a lot of people have been wanting this game. It's a very special edition. It's probably one of the first of its kind, probably. I don't know. But anyway, let's get into it. So, the basics of this game is basically you have to survive. The end game is you have to either get to the boat, or you have to survive the total 14 days invasion time, running with these tripods running around trying to kill you, and you have to survive with food and water. See, there's one over there, if you can see it. We actually went for a PS1 kind of style pixelated aesthetic to it to kind of add to the uniqueness to it and kind of adds to the scariness level. But yeah, there's no sounds in the game currently. We're still working on that. Again, this is very, very, very alpha. But as you can see, you have to survive with food and water. And I believe, yeah, for the first 3 days, if they get you, they will zap you to death. And then after the 3 days, rather than zapping you, they will start grabbing you instead and harvesting you. There's a total of, what was it, 6 cities or something? I forgot. But there's one over there too. There's a total of 6 tripods that spawn, and it takes about, I can't even get over there, it's over there. Total of, they see me. I gotta get out of here. There's a total of 6 tripods that will spawn, and this map is actually pretty large. It takes about 15 minutes to walk across. Yeah, but the tripod designs are not final. They're kind of just walking tin boxes at the moment. We're still kind of debating on a tripod design, but as of right now, they do work. They just kind of look a little bit weird, and they don't look really like alien-like or tripod-like, or where the world's like. But yeah, they're there. And as you can see, there's a day and night cycle. I think we have a 10-minute day and 10-minute night, total 20-minute day. I think this is shorter because we're in the testing phases right now, but that will change probably. How much food and water do I have? Okay, I still have plenty. Actually, as of right now in this version that I'm playing, actually, that goes on forever. There is no cap at the 14-day mark. They will have walking sounds, horns, all kinds of, like, you know, all that. We do plan on adding, NPCs, not ones you can interact with, maybe, I don't know, that kind of just roam around the map and then kind of gives the tripods something to get, like, do. It just kind of, like, they attack them, they grab them, they'll do all kinds of stuff. See, there's one over there, too. Am I being chased? What's good about this is the day and night cycle, it's realistic because you can't see anything in the dark. So it's kind of, you have to kind of assess what you're gonna do. Because you can't just go roaming around in the middle of the night like I'm doing, otherwise you're probably gonna get caught. There's one over there. I think we're going to tone down the pixelation a little bit because it's kind of hard to see the tripods in the distance. But it is a little bit difficult. There's is over there. Might have to... Ah, crap, he sees me. He's going to come after me now. Run! Crap, he's blocking my way now. But yeah, again, this will be released tomorrow. May 30th of this video. It'll probably change very little from what you're seeing right now. We might add like a tiny bit more and kind of change some stuff, but this is what you're seeing is probably what's going to be in the public version or the very first version. He sees me. He sees me. And then you can go in the water too. And I do believe the tripods can walk in the water too. We do plan on adding military intervention, which means that there will be, like, warships off in the sea trying to attack this thing, and some like ground units trying to attack it. I'll actually leave a link in the description to the Trello, which shows what we've done, what we're adding, and so on and so on. I have to kind of be stealthy here. So yeah, it's kind of difficult because you have to keep moving, otherwise you're probably gonna get caught or you're gonna run out of food. Like I said, I think we're gonna tone down the pixelation a little bit because it kind of messes with the draw distance. It kind of makes the tripod's hard to see, and he's gonna zap me, isn't he? Ah, crap. Yeah, I can't see him anymore. I can kind of see him. We do plan on adding fog lights too, so you can kind of figure out where they are. Because right now they're just kind of not even visible. Which kind of will add to the scary aesthetic too, because you can kind of see the fog lights in the distance coming towards you, or kind of just out there. We also plan on adding the horns to be able to be heard from in the distance, not just like right up close. I'm not going to show you what guys the horn is. That's for you guys to figure out once we actually get that added. But there will be that. I'm running out of water. I need to drink some. Uh-oh. I said we have to fix that. Oops. Got a glitch. Won't let me consume anything. Hold on, am I just not pressing something right? I need to look at the keybinds again. Yeah, something's wrong here. I'm trying to click everything and it's not exactly working. And I'm probably gonna get zapped by this thing. No, I got away. I need to figure that out. Why is it doing that? I don't know. I'll figure it out later. I'll fix it. Whoa, what the heck? Another glitch? Again, it's alpha, so there's gonna be a lot of like problems. I don't know why it looks like I'm freaking walking on thin air right now. That's weird. I don't know why it did that. Maybe I can get past him. There's something over there. I think that's a. Or wait, that's a tree trunk, not a building. I don't know why it did that. That's weird. That is really weird. Okay, now it's back down. I don't know. We're gonna have to fix that. Again, like I said, this is extremely bare bones, so there's gonna be problems like this, and walking on thin air, and food not working, and he sees me. As you can see, they do knock down trees. And they can destroy small buildings. Like there's something over here. Did I already get to that? I think I did. Oh crap, there's another one over there. As you can see, it's kind of pretty difficult to kind of get around, and you have to kind of assess where, how you're gonna do it, avoid getting caught. And we do, this is the permadeath scenario, meaning like if you die, that's it. So you could be on day 8 and get killed, and then you have to start completely over. But there will be a save function to where you can, if you survive like the day 3 and you want to stop, and it'll save it. It won't like start over. Alright, I think we're gonna wrap up the video here, so I'm gonna go ahead and just show you guys what it's like to be zapped by one as soon as it gets into daytime, because it's kind of hard to see at night. But yeah, there's quite a few number of glitches going on right now we're gonna have to look at. I don't know why it's doing that we looked at it, but I don't know. But again, it's alpha. We do plan on adding some, of course, textures, because some of the textures are missing. As you can see, I don't know if you saw it before, but there was like a white box in the corner that's a missing texture that they see you. So when you guys play this and you see that white texture up in the right above the day number, that means they see you, and you kind of have to get out of there. Or otherwise you risk it getting zapped or caught, like as you can see that white box, that means they see you. I can't even see anything right now. We also plan on maybe late roadmap VR support. We're still kind of debating on how we're gonna do that. Because right now we're just mainly focusing on getting the game playable and fun rather before we start considering VR. Because I don't know about you, but this game would look really cool in VR. Because again, this is probably one of the very first actual legit survival games based on the War of the Worlds. Let me just show you guys how what it's like to be zapped by one. Yep, instant, just death. When they do grab you, they'll kind of hold you with their tentacles a little bit, and then they'll just throw you into the machine, and that's when you die. But yeah, this is the game. It'll be out tomorrow, May 30th, and I hope you guys enjoyed the video.